Hello, everybody. Luke back once again. This time we're going to be breaking down some E3 news. We're getting a lot of new games being announced, including a brand new RPG that's in development right now, The Outer Worlds 2. Now, the original Outer Worlds is an action RPG game developed by Obsidian, and it's very popular. A lot of gamers love the fact that the decisions you made early are going to greatly affect the outcome. Befriend somebody, kill somebody, fight somebody, or let them go will have big impacts on how the story develops. It's one of the games that's really tried to dive far into that. Now we're seeing a new game come out that promises to really build on that success that was announced at E3. Now in this video, we're going to be breaking down everything we know about the game and some of the credible rumors out there around it and some leaks. Though I'll warn you, not a lot's known about it, but we're going to be breaking down what we do know and let you know what's being said out there amongst the circles they're in the know about the game. First though, if you're new here, do me a big favor, hit that subscribe button, hit that thumbs up. It really does help us because it lets YouTube know you enjoy what we do here, and hopefully we can help you learn something new about the world of gaming as we grow this brand new gaming channel, trying to hit 1,000 subscribers. Could you help us out? Hit that subscribe button. We would really appreciate it. Now, the original game not only focused on a huge branching storyline, but also a ton of weapons to pick from to decide how you want to play. If you want to be a sniper, if you want to get in the melee, you can build up your weapons the way you want to play the game, which is something a lot of people loved. Now with the second version, the developers hope to build on this to give you even more customizable way to do the combat in this first-person RPG game. Of course, RPG will be a big part of it as you level up different skills, will affect the way you play, but also what equipment you take on. Now this time the game will be set in a totally new solar system with a new crew, but the same Outer Worlds feel. Now this means the creators are hitting a big massive reset button on the game in order to give you the ability to start afresh with it. So if you're a fan of the original, it'll be interesting to see if there's any callbacks to the original, or if they're just going to pretend like it never happened in a very Final Fantasy-esque style reset that you see a lot of them. The creators also reportedly are working very hard to make each branching storyline different, unique. How you play the game, minor decisions that may not seem all that important, can affect you very far down the path, which should be interesting. Now, this has been a big trend in gaming. Now, Mass Effect was one of the bigger games to get this started earlier. I know there's been many other ones out there, but many other RPGs are really trying to do that. Now, branching storylines and more are not necessarily new. What's new here is the minute changes really having such a massive impact. In previous games, you still kind of bounced around between a central story, and you weren't able to diverge too far from it, even though there were some games, like the Star Wars RPGs, that did allow you a little bit more variety in how you played it out. Now, with the new game systems and new engines, you're able to do a lot more, where you can truly have a massive selection of endings instead of just 4 or 5 to pick from. Possibly could be hundreds. It'd be interesting to see how far the Outer Worlds pushes this into multiple different endings. Is this just going to end up with 4 or 5? Or are we really talking about hundreds of different combinations that you could find yourself at the end of the game? It'd be kind of interesting to see how far they push this with modern technology that could really handle such difficult compression, difficult processing decisions, and more. Now, the game is in very early development. Reports are putting this more as a 2023 game. We can confirm it's being developed. But even in the trailer, they poke fun at the fact that many of the things you're seeing on screen here in their trailer are not things you're going to actually see as you go through the game. Now, that's kind of a fun little third wall break they're doing. There is a possibility. Some people say it could come out in 2022, but most reports are pegging this as a 2023 release and a late 2023 release. Kind of be a fall blockbuster. We'll have to wait and see how this comes out. This far out, if we've learned anything from 2020's pandemic year, things change, and it's very possible that this game could change also. Now, for support platforms, it's been confirmed for the PC and Xbox next gen, though that doesn't necessarily mean that PS5 support won't happen, since this was announced at an Xbox event. It's not unusual for them to announce it just for that console at that event, and then at a later date announce other consoles. Though, would not surprise me that this is an Xbox exclusive, but the fact that they haven't said that yet is a good news. It does apparently probably be coming to Game Pass. That was reported in several sources, but I was not able to fully confirm that by the time I'm recording this right after it was announced. So if that wasn't 100% confirmed, leave me a comment. Let me know. All right, so that's what we know. It's definitely a lot out there. There are a lot of other rumors, though, things that aren't confirmed. Now, one of the things that has really been leaked or suggested about this game, unconfirmed, is that a reset will be very important with this game, that they want to kind of hit the reset button, like we talked about early, in a massive way, much like a Final Fantasy game. Well, Final Fantasy has a certain style and a certain feel. Each game traditionally has a reset. There are a few sequels and direct continuations, but the vast majority of the games are complete resets, but within a certain game frame of game style. And that's what I would expect from this, according to reports. So keep that in mind. Don't be feeling like you're going to get an exact copy or exact sequel. That is probably not going to happen. For now, we'll be keeping a close eye on this, and as we learn more, we'll be posting additional videos. So if you like this, hit that subscribe button, hit that thumbs up. It really does help us. And hopefully we can help you learn something new about the world of gaming and help us hit that 1,000 subscriber count that we've been working for. And just having a few months of this game channel. Thank you to all of our new subscribers. There have been so many just in the last couple days. All right, we'll be back with another video real soon. Check back for more of our E3 coverage. Thanks for your support. I really appreciate it.